Hey guys, Zachary James Steele here for the World of Allegora LARP. Today we'll be teaching you how to make a two-handed sword, or what we call a red weapon. Supplies you will need: a marker, box cutter, scissors, a tape measure, an optional pipe cutter. You also need a counterbalance. Any weighted metal such as bolts, nuts, washers, or loose chains balance your sword. Adhesive glue and tape. Cloth and or decorative tape. Rope, paracord, or leather. Blue camp foam. For extra safety, we're going to apply some open cell foam. PVC or fiberglass. In this project, we'll be using fiberglass rod, which is a lot stronger core than PVC. However, it is harder to find and normally found online only. Although you can still use PVC, it is cheaper and way easier to find in hardware stores. However, it's not as sturdy and does flex more. You want to start out by measuring the width of the blue foam compared to the core you're using. Cut about 4 strips like this. Next, glue your core in strips. Wait 3 to 5 minutes for them to get tacky. Make sure the entire strip has enough glue like this. Next, lay the strip down on the core like this. Use some force to make sure they're securely on. Next, lay the second one. Next, use some tape to reinforce everything, making sure it won't come off the core. Trim excess to even everything up. Now you can start measuring the actual cutting edge. Do so like this. It's easier to cut as one strip to wrap around. Once that's done, start cutting. It should look something like this. Next, spray some glue on the unpadded sides. Wait till it gets tacky and then start wrapping your foam around it like this. Make sure you use some force to make sure everything is pressed down and glued securely. It should look something like this. Take your open cell foam, glue it, and then when it's tacky, put it on the tip. Then reinforce it with duct tape, making sure not to compress the foam. Since the tip adds extra length, you'll have to remeasure the next layer. And place the third layer on, just like normal. Make sure as you go over the tip, you do not compress the foam. Make sure it still shows give, then trim any excess. Next, reinforce everything with a few strips of tape, not compressing the foam with this step as well. Add extra tape to the tip to make it secure, still making sure it has plenty of give. And remember guys, as you're making your weapons, especially before decorating them, you want to make sure that you test your weapons to make sure they are legal before you decorate them.
Good.
Alright, and arm.
Good.
Alright, cool. If the sword passes, the light, medium, and hard test, you're ready to go, you're ready to decorate. Alright, let's get started. Next, to add some decoration, we're going to draw a blade guard. Draw any design you like. Measure out and find the middle, and then draw a hole just big enough for your core to fit through. And then cut it out. Your core should fit through like this. Now I'm going to take a knife or box cutter to cut slits down because I want my blade guard to go up at a slight angle. I'm going to glue and tape it up like this. Next, get any weight you'll like to be using. The counterbalance will make the sword not feel as heavy and easier to wield. Make sure you secure the counterbalance very firmly to the core where it will not move. Use any kind of splinting method or whatever. This will be hidden in your hilt. Once it's secure, cut your foam out to foam over it. Measure out, glue, and tape your foam like so. covering all parts of the counterbalance. Make sure everything is covered in foam, just in case your counterbalance accidentally hits someone. Spray glue over the handle. I'll be adding rope for a better grip and looks. Wrap it like so. If using PVC pipe, you can always put PVC insulation over it and wrap it in electrical tape. For decoration, you can choose to cloth or tape your weapon. If clothing, cut out two half templates. Then glue your sword. Get each half and put it on the sword like this, making sure it's taut. Press down firmly to make sure it's on. Do that to both sides. I went ahead and finished the pommel and blade guard with some black tape. And there you have it, we're done. There's our red weapon. Oh, well, hey there. I guess that takes care of that tutorial now, doesn't it? Please comment, like, and subscribe to our channel. You can also check out our website in the description below, or just Google the word Allegora, Allegora. The world of Allegora. Create yourself.